Hi, I'm Sean. I'm a key account manager with Shanghai Optics. Today, we're going to be talking to you about what is reverse engineering. So reverse engineering really consists of three different elements. It's a process of gaining the original design data and product performance by disabling and testing the product. Reverse engineering involves product performance testing, individual optical component analysis, and mechanical part mapping. It's really a great way to recreate and optimize designs for items that went out of production or are not properly documented. So some common uses for reverse engineering. Number one, recreating obsolete components. Over time, companies can drop their product lines. They might change their specifications or they might go out of business altogether. Supply chain interruptions can bring your production to really a complete halt. So reverse engineering is going to be an excellent solution for obtaining the design information and recreating lens components. Number two, I would say replacing expensive OTS lenses used in your product. So off-the-shelf parts are usually a great design for general applications. They consist of many elements and also are very expensive. It's not uncommon that design engineers select standard off-the-shelf optical components for checking the concept design or building prototypes without considering the complexity of the system and production costs. So reverse engineering is really going to help recreate the lenses with all the required properties for lower production costs. Number three, regaining the design data for long discontinued products. So some older products that have not been manufactured for 20 years or more, those original 2D drawings or design files are no longer available. Often there will be no way to contact the original designers. So how we help with reverse engineering is we can help with regaining the lost designs and rebuild those old products. Number four, improving the existing product performance. The existing product may not work well for new or more critical applications. Reverse engineering techniques can help play an important role in failure analysis. Taking apart or examining the product can help create the original design. From there, you can modify the design for improving product performance. Number five, bringing less expensive or more efficient products to the market. Reverse engineering process can help engineers discover existing product design, which could be more useful for your new product design. Reverse engineering leads engineers on a path towards more efficient solutions, which helps lower your manufacturing costs and enhance product performance in a more economic way. This is just a chart of the process for reverse engineering. So when you send us your sample, we're going to take that sample and we're going to disassemble and map the piece. These are some of the metrology equipment that we have in-house to help with the process. Our optics testing and mechanical parts mapping is the next process and next phase in the process. The tasks that are involved with that include dimensioning, radius, surface accuracy, airspace, centering, coating, and refractive index. From that point, once we pass that phase, we're ready to go into the redesign phase. And we're going to input test data, adjust airspace, we're going to optimize the performance, general lens data, and the approval from the customer as well. So these are the services that are included with reverse engineering: lens component reverse engineering, lens assembly reverse engineering, tolerance analysis, redesign and optimization for meeting both cost and performance requirements, prototyping. So once you're ready to go into your prototyping, we could help you out there. And then once it passes your prototyping phase, that's going to lead to mass production as well. And we'll be able to handle those high volumes for you. My name is Sean. Again, I'm a key account manager with Shanghai Optics. I appreciate your time. For more information, you can check our website out at www.shanghai-optics.com. I appreciate your time. Thanks.